Hi guys, in this lesson I will show you how to use some basic functions of Corona that you can take advantage of even if you have never used this render engine before. In particular, we show you how to create materials using presets, how to associate a material from the Corona library which is already included with software, and how to import objects from the Cosmos library. So let's start with this scene and this shot. At the moment we don't have any lights, so we can add a Corona sun. By clicking on this icon, we click and drag and give it an angle of about 45 degrees. Then in the properties, we select Add Corona Sky Environment. At this point, by selecting this viewport and by clicking on the interactive render icon, we can already get an idea of the current stage. Obviously, with the current setting, the image appears excessively overexposed. So let's go into the camera properties, and in the Edit Tone Mapping section, we can slightly reduce the exposure. Just one point. But above all, we can activate the transformation of colors in the axis space, which allows to eliminate overexposure while maintaining an interesting color distribution. This type of transformation also gives a touch of photorealism to the image. As I told you, we will use preset materials of the Corona physical material, materials from the Corona library, and finally objects from the Cosmos library. The license for the Cosmos library is included in the Corona software, and it's part of the package you can get by signing up of my course. Now, we select the floor, and then from the library, which we can open by clicking on this icon, let's go to the ceramic tiles section, where we find a selection of flooring. At this point, we select the floor. Then with the right button on this material, we click on Assign Selected Object. And here the flooring is assigned directly from the library. However, we must be sure that the flooring we are assigning respects the original proportions. In fact, we see that some floors are 30 by 30, while others are 60 by 30. To make sure that the surface that this flooring shows respects your original aspect ratio, we simply need to assign the UVW map modifier to the plane and activate the Real World Map Sites option. This way, we are sure that any map we assign will respect the original aspect ratio. Now, we can assign this map too, or any other from the entire library. For this exercise, I've selected Tails Zigzag. Then right-click, Assign Selected Object, and here is the applied material. As this floor is slightly darker, the amount of light in the room tends to decrease a bit. So we can go back to the Edit Tone Mapping and increase exposure to zero. Actually, we can do this at any time, but I preferred to do it immediately, so I can put immediately in balance the sunlight with the final flooring. As previously said, we can also apply some preset materials directly from the Corona physical material. For instance, I want to give this floor lamp the metal chrome, so I select these two pieces that I see here, and then we go to the material editor. To create a new material, I select Corona physical material And here, in this section right at the beginning of the material, we have presets that we can apply. In particular, in this case, I select Chrome and associate it with the object. As you can see, every time I make a change, since we have activated the interactive rendering in real time, the image is updated with each change. And here is the metal chrome. At the table instead, I want to assign a gray glossy plastic. Then again, I select Corona physical material. And from here, since we don't have a ready-made plastic of the color I want, I start by choosing plastic PVC opaque. I select the table and modify it using the color I want. At this point, after the material library and after the Corona physical material presets, we are going to add objects directly from the Cosmos library, which is included in the Corona license. Cosmos has this icon, so I click on it, and to start, we insert some stools. Then I look for a stool in the library, and here some appear to me. I had this already downloaded and saved on my computer, so I just click on the import button to see it directly on stage. When objects are imported from the CAUS library, they always appear at coordinate 0,0 of our scene. Then from here, we drag them where necessary. Okay, for now I temporarily disabled interactive rendering to handle our objects more comfortably. I create some instances and place them within our frame. Now, little by little, we can compose the scene and, as announced, we will always and only do with library elements. For instance, to make this area less flat, where direct sunlight hits, we can place a tree outside our scene to make it cast shadows inside. So, I do the steps again. I go to Cosmos and look for a tree. In the download section, there are trees that I have already downloaded, which therefore they are already on my workstation. Okay, I think this tree is suitable for my purpose, then I import it. Now we also see it at coordinates 0,0. At this moment, the tree is displayed as transparent box because it is a proxy, and by default it is imported into the scene according to this display method, which is wirebox. I can work with this way without any problem, but I can also see its original shape if I select Full Mesh here. And here is the effect I wanted to achieve. Of course, now, by inserting a tree and other darker objects, the brightness in the scene tends to decrease, but we will resolve it eventually at the end of the process. Now let's go to add other objects. Since we have blue stools, to have a high chromatic contrast, we can use its primary complementary color, that is, the yellow. So let's look for something that has to do with, for example, lemons. Great, this is just perfect for this scene. I don't have this model on my computer right now, so I click to download, wait just a few seconds, and then click to import. I move it around the scene and place it on the table. Now let's add a few more elements, for example, objects that have to do with breakfast and plants on the right and left to enrich and complete the composition. As I mentioned, the models can be imported, but then obviously they can also be modified. For example, I want a lighter wood for these tools. I can modify the material of these tools in this way. I open the material editor. I select it with the material picker, and we see that it's made of a multi-sub-object material. The wood we want to modify is the number 6. In fact, if I turn it off, it disappears. What we can do in this case is to enter the wood material, then enter the map that represents its diffuse color, and in the output section enable color map. Then just act on the curve, just like it was a curve of Photoshop, to lighten the image. As you can see in the preview, now the wood is lighter and thus becomes lighter in the rendering as well. At this point, I want to give this table a final touch. Since we have used blue and yellow, I want to make this table legs yellow plastic. You will see that it will really make a great effect. So I select the table legs, and let's create another material, always starting from the materials that we have available. So I select a Corona physical material. In this case, here we don't have a ready-made transparent yellow plastic available, but we can start from this glass architectural. I assign it, and then I go to the media options. And here we see absorption color, there is a slightly hint of a light green. I turn it into yellow. So let's go back to the edit tone mapping section to complete the image by finding the most suitable exposure. In this case, we can try to increase half a point exposure or a little more. We can also increase the contrast, which always gives a more appropriate photographic look. And finally, as a last step, we can enable the bloom and glare option, which creates these glows which are very realistic. In particular, I want to slightly increase the effect of glare by increasing this value from 1 to 3. So I get this sort of nice stars in the overexposed areas. Obviously, this image works and has a nice impact because there are a series of elements I already prepared in advance. In particular, the composition is well structured, the type of focal length I've chosen works well this type of framing, the relationship between the light and the camera angle also respects all the rules of correct lighting. You will find all these topics explained in detail with many examples within my Corona course. All'interno del corso.